Ontsteekt het stadion in woede. Terwijl 5 jaar geleden, toen ik hier nog woonde, het ANC 2/3 meerderheid in het parlement had, eigenlijk een eenpartijstaat was bijna, met Zuma als boegbeeld daarvan. Ook een onaantastbare leider leek het toen, maar nu, ze moeten hem gewoon niet meer. Hoe beschamend kan het zijn op de herdenkingsdag van Mandela, dat je dan zo te kijken wordt gezet? Wat is aan de hand met dit land?
Nelson Mandela sterft in de week waarin ik na 5 jaar terugkeer naar Zuid-Afrika. Alsof hij op me heeft gewacht, zo voelt het. Dit is nu mijn tweede thuisland. De plek die zo onder mijn huid is gekropen dat ik de roep om terug te komen niet kon weerstaan. Het licht hier, de lucht, de verhalen. Aan deze straat alleen al heb ik zoveel herinneringen. Niet allemaal even mooi trouwens.
Ja, dit is hem. Nummer 74 Fifth Avenue. Dit is het huis waar ik 7 jaar lang gewoond heb, voordat ik naar Turkije ging. Hier zaten ooit houten deuren in, totdat op een nacht de overvallers hier bij de deur kwamen en met een hakbijl probeerden binnen te komen. Toen hebben ze gelukkig nog weg weten te jagen, maar voor de zekerheid heb ik er toen maar een stalen deur in gezet. En die houdt het nog wel even. Ik heb nog steeds sleutels. Kijk of die doet. Ja, dit is echt Johannesburg Living, hè? Hoge muren, prikkeldraad en heel veel sleutels. Hij doet het nog. Kijk. Vermeulen. B. 74 Melville. Nog steeds van mij. En mijn hondje. Blanca. Ja. Ja. Ja, ik heb hem nog. Is Blanca. Alleen, ik heb er nu huurders in zitten. En die vonden de naam Blanca te racistisch voor Zuid-Afrika. Dus die hebben hem Yasha genoemd. Dus, ik heb nog wel een hond. Alleen zijn naam kent hij niet meer. Kom maar.
Niets in dit land is onaangetast door de verhoudingen tussen de rassen. De last van 40 jaar apartheid hangt hier nog altijd boven ieder gesprek. Als een zwaard van Damocles. Mandela sleept wel de scherpe kantjes ervan af met zijn taal van verzoening. Maar je hoeft alleen maar rond te kijken in de duurste wijken van de stad en je ziet het blijvende probleem. 20 jaar later is Zuid-Afrika nog steeds een van de meest ongelijke samenlevingen ter wereld. De zwarte middenklasse groeit en trekt zich terug achter dezelfde hoge muren en dezelfde dromen over hebben dingetjes. Maar aan de randen van de stad groeit de woede op de partij van Mandela en zijn opvolgers.
Dit is de tijd voor EFF. Fuck Zoom. Kom. Malema is already talking, guys. Come on, come inside. Come inside.
What's that? I don't get another fighter. Come on, fighters.
Is he in already?
Yes, he's
in already.
Yes.
Malema is in already.
Just come, go straight. Yes.
This is the time for EFF. This is a radical change. Away! Amanda!
Hello, Mantashe Wako. Ole mene mene. When Azuma. Ole mene mene.
Amanda! Away!
20 years into democracy. Le santi mo maemong a lentseng ona a. Ke le nare lwa le lena hore le tswe mo seemong sa lena. Ka hore apartheid e o fa metse, freedom a e o fe metse. What is there to celebrate? Nelson Mandela, wherever he is, he must be turning in his grave. Hore bana ba hae ba sa sotla ke tlala. Hore bana ba hae ba robala ba se baji. Hore bana ba hae ba ya dikolong ba se ba apare dieta. Wena motswadi wa hao ile sekolong a sa apara seeta. We must give the ANC a wake-up call.
Amanda! Amanda! Makakandwe uJacob Zuma nesibaya sakhe makakandwe. Makakandwe uJacob Zuma nesibaya sakhe makakandwe. Makakandwe uKiti Mabuza neprivate bank yakhe makakandwe.
Mr. Malema,
how are you?
How are you doing? Long
good.
Pleased to meet you.
Yes.
Why does Julius Malema understand the plight of the poor better than the ANC?
Because the ANC is compromised, is led by capital, which is in bed with the leadership.
Yeah.
And the leadership wants to impress capital more than the people. They have replaced the word people with investors. So every time they speak, they say investor this, investor that. But they are referring to themselves and their business partners. Yes.
And who is Julius Malema to say all these things? I mean, what's your background? Who's your mother? Who's your father?
I come from a very poor background. My mother was a domestic worker who was suffering from epilepsy. And she stayed in a shack in the back room of her mother's house. We used to go to school without shoes. We went to school without meal. We were a big family, staying in a four-roomed house, and we're not less than 20. So that's where I come from, and that's why I can easily understand the plight of the poor masses of our people. And when you talk poverty, I don't rely on newspapers and statistics. I know it.
Ah, mon foulou.
Did he tell you?
What did you think of Malema's speech?
It inspired the people.
Did it inspire you?
It did. It did. I think he's one of the leaders that South Africa needs right now, at this present moment. He's one of the people who can articulate himself and really speak for the people.
Ik zag Malema altijd als een aandachtstrekker, die nadat hij uit de regeringspartij werd gezet, als een kind met zijn speelgoed begon te gooien, boos op iedereen, verzet als handelsmerk. Maar net als bij mijn jonge chauffeur raakt hij bij veel zwarte Zuid-Afrikanen een gevoelige snaar. Er broeit iets in dit land, een woede die ik nog niet eerder tegenkwam.
We rijden nu naar het noordoosten van Zuid-Afrika en dat is de plek waar het geld wordt verdiend in dit land. Daar liggen de platinamijnen. En ja, er is eigenlijk geen plek in dit land waar je beter kunt voelen wat er hier is veranderd als de plek waar we nu naartoe rijden, Marikana.
Marikana is nu het symbool voor alles wat mis is gegaan in Zuid-Afrika. 2 jaar geleden legden mijnwerkers hier wekenlang het werk neer omdat ze beter betaald wilden worden. Totdat het geduld van de Britse eigenaar van de platinamijn op was en de politie erbij haalde om een einde te maken aan die staking. Het hadden beelden kunnen zijn uit de apartheidstijd, maar het was de politie van de ANC-regering, de partij van Mandela, die het vuur opende op de mijnwerkers. ...34 mijnwerkers dood in een paar minuten tijd.
Dit is hem, hè? Een hele beladen plek. Dit is de Wonderkop. De plek waar die mijnwerkers dagenlang achter elkaar hebben gezeten. In de hoop dat hun staking zou leiden tot een verdrievoudiging van hun salaris. En je zie je hoe dicht het allemaal op elkaar ligt. Hè? Nog steeds diezelfde huisjes gemaakt van wrakhout, van golfplaten. En dan hier aan de overkant van de weg, de mijn van Lonmin. De plek waar de platina uit de grond wordt gehaald.
I don't know what it's in danger because... Nam ben corner, papa. Ik ben lekker. Ik ben lost. Ik heb het niet gezien. Als je het gezien hebt, dan heb je het gezien. Ik heb het from my head. But just because. So, I not think what you think that is in our pen is to lay bread because the scat box and then when they are lost in Jubon and Jugutu Center because facing Yam as an skin, Ben Nekas like a band to be to kill a one from Guam, Yabon, Quenzaga Yongin, even Nam Benning Ashwa and Nang my bangas card. Best corner one among my Ben now up, but luck Tango Pook. Ben now among my but Benning up believe what Samba Street, Gentle Begins, a husband, Ben Hitigi, Noms Bam Duba.
Did you have a weapon on you?
For
Did you have like a knife or a spear or a gun? Yeah,
no, not gun. Just you, what in? Is kun induk. Yes. Weapon, yeah.
Like a spear, the Zulu spear.
Yes, yeah, Zulu spear. Zulu spear, yeah.
Like a stick. A
stick, yes, like stick. Then I will come, you weapon. Then I will come because you need, you put for you, you have for Zulu stick on the side for mounting. Then you come for weapon, good use for in the club.
And gun? Pistol?
Gun for workers. I not gun every somebody.
No guns.
No gun.
Because the police said the mine workers had guns.
Aye, not true. And not true.
Are you still working in the Lonmin mine?
Yeah, me, you working.
You're still going down every
day? Yes, underground, every day, even much. You come for underground, but just you use for 15 minutes and you tell everything, so you use us. But...
Why don't you leave?
You leave what?
Why don't you leave?
For...
Somewhere else?
Yeah, because of... you work, even nobody you live inside. Like next mine, no week. Yeah, that is why you have stayed here. That is. So are you hated?
De mijnindustrie in Zuid-Afrika is een reliquie uit de apartheidstijd. Groot geworden dankzij die massa's slecht betaalde mijnwerkers die werden geronseld in de armste provincies van het land en maandenlang van huis zijn om geld voor hun familie te verdienen. Tijdens de apartheid protesteerde het ANC tegen die barre werkomstandigheden. Maar ook al is het ANC nu 20 jaar aan de macht, de mijnwerkers voelen dat er nauwelijks iets is veranderd.
Nempilo ngoku iyaleqeka nayo ngoba lo moya lo yena khona lapha ngoloka lonkani ayikhona moya yena fanana nalo moya lo nalo mpilo thina gcwala sibhedlela futhi losikhathi yena khona sibhedlela wena ihola losikhathi yena kuphelile 21 days nakhuluma lo masikini othi kawena yena phelile wena ihola losikhathi yena khona nalo mfazi lapha wena sokola kuphela. When I eat, when I'm a tank, lapa galomunye mapululu. When I call, those guys in a pelil in 21 days. Tralomale in a pelil, the signal can't win on a kulil lapa galum coat.
Hello, hello. How are you? Shall I put my shoes off? Because they're very muddy. Good evening.
This is him. Ah, he's still young.
Yeah, 1974.
1974, as is as old as me. And he had his card for working in Lonmin. This is from the mine, huh? What's his name?
Mphumzeni.
Mphumzeni.
Ethethe ukuthi aphumza abantu ifamily yakhe, uma wakhe noma tata wakhe baphumule. Ngamxelela ukuthi ukuphi na wathi basentabeni. Ndathi ufunani apho, wathi badutyule so bawohlala into bawolanta kentabeni. Ndathi ukuthi makangayi mina ndithi mathi makabuye. Wathi akakwazi ukuthi angabuya because imali uyayifuna and usebenza nzima.
You didn't say don't go. Don't go strike.
Hey, I'm ndamxelela ukuthi angayi makangayi strikini. So wathi andikwazi ukuthi ndiyi RDO thingayi estrikini because imali ndiyayifuna. And imali le uyidingayo nawe. Ndamyeka ukuthi ahambe. Ebenithanda kakhulu nabantwana bakhe bathanda kakhulu ebenzela yonke into abayifunayo abantwana bakhe esinqonile ukuthi bangadingi into uba bafuni yonke Christmas uthengela abantwana bakhe impahla ze Christmas ufuna ukuthi abantwana babheke esikolweni nami engathanda ukuthi msokole imali ebeke ninikeza kangako.
Would you blame for all of this?
Oqala ndiyababhlema abantu be-NUM and ne Lonmin they blame
the mine
amapolisa
and the police
because inam ayikwazanga ubathethela abantu bayo emlungwini isuka yona yabadubula abantu bayo iLonmin yona ndiyiblema ngokubiza amapolisa abizele abantu bakhe abaqeshila axa ukuthi athethe nabo ababizele amapolisi ukuthi ababulale uLonmini naye ndiyamblame kakhulu ngoba napha kwi-commission izecurity zaseLonmini sizibonile pha siphethe imipu sidubula abantu entabeni amapolisa wona ndiqonda uba into edala uba ndiwablame wona ayingafanelanga ngifika abulale ndicinga uba ngabantu boxoba bakudala uba abantu bakhusela abantu. So bona babe ngazange uzokukhusela babe zobabulala.
Marikana is een kras in het collectief geheugen van Zuid-Afrika. De regering die aan de macht kwam met de strijd voor arme zwarte Zuid-Afrikanen, mijnwerkers als deze, opent het vuur op zijn eigen volk, zijn eigen kiezers.
The electronic record will show conclusively that there was no tear gas, and we would put also that there were no stun grenades. But let's see what there was, and that we see in slide 200 of Exhibit L, was the gap that hadn't yet been closed by barbed wire from Nyala 4, and I'm going to identify the barbed wire from Nyala 4. It's the dotted yellow line that stretches.
Kopa ukulahleka komntwana nami kwasiphatha kabuhlungu kakhulu siyifamily. Uthathe ubula kwabuhlungu, udutyulwe ngapha ngasemva esinqeni, imbombulu yazophuma lapha enhlizweni, amanxeba ayi-2. Waphinda wadutyulwa nangezabereks eziya apha enkalweni.
Mapolisa.
Namapolisa. Ndandisebenza emgodini neminyaka eyi-30. Ndisebenza emayini mna iminyaka engama-30. Ndabanjwa yi-tisis isihlandlo esibini. Kwathiwa mandibuyise unyana wam loo ndafakayo.
So you send your son to the mine?
Yes, but athumele unyana wami emayini uyongivala ngokwemvume yemayini. Kanti ndimsekufeni umntana xa yokhalela imali engamoshanga.
Those people who died in Marikana. Baba Bulaya, Barba Hupela increase, Bayo Sapota Malapabona, Barba Hupela increase, Bayo Patel Labanabona di Kolo, Bahupela increase, or Babelo Pelobo Kaune, Baba Tunya, Baba Bulaya, Barbala Fazi, until by Basho Urkam Kabarubich. Lives.
Zo interessant wat hij doet, want eigenlijk kun je de geschiedenis van Zuid-Afrika, die begint steeds in 1994. En alles daarvoor was slecht en alles daarna was goed. En hij zegt, we zijn nu 20 jaar verder, nu is het genoeg geweest. We hebben dankjewel gezegd voor die geschiedenis, voor de bevrijding van de blanken. Maar nu moeten we het ergens anders over hebben. En dan legt hij eigenlijk een nieuw punt in die geschiedenis. En dat is Marikana. De moord op 34 mijnwerkers in de mijnen. Daar moeten we het nu over hebben, zegt hij. En daarmee legt hij vinger op de gevoelige plek.
We must give you the mine, the support of Banavalena, the Arele di Kolo, the Arele di Clinic. There is too much money in the mines. Marabatia Cheleteu, Baisha London, Baisha America, Basishie Selo Mo Africa. Renyaka or the mine, the Hule Banaba Africa Bura. Refepe Banava Rena, Refepe Se Chaba. Rebuild a prosperous South Africa. Your time for economic freedom is now. Political freedom without economic freedom is an incomplete freedom.
De protestnatie. Dat is het land dat Mandela achterlaat. Gemiddeld 5 keer per dag wordt er wel ergens in Zuid-Afrika gedemonstreerd tegen de gebroken belofte van zijn ANC. De erfenis van apartheid is niet langer een geldig excuus voor een populist als Malema, die zich laaft aan die teleurstelling en hem verder voedt.
You live here. Do you feel that the attitude of the workers has changed recently, that they don't allow it anymore?
You mean they don't, they have become negative too? Yeah, really the truth is that I've said, you know, everyone, workers and communities alike, really the attitude has hardened, both towards the authority, towards the corporations, you know. People are living in shacks. When you talk about mining industry, then we are talking about the world of shacks. Yeah. Mining companies have failed to house their employees. That is a fact. And it has been going on. And the most painful part of it is that most of our leaders are trade unionists. And in the 80s, they used to compare this living, these hostels, mining hostels, as the Nazi camp, concentration camps, and all those kind of things. But ever since they took power, nothing has changed. And it has obviously led to the killing of the workers. It has led to instability in the communities. It shows really that you know, those that are in power, they care less about the people. That is why even when they designed the structure of trying to stabilize it, they never ever considered, yeah, showing us that we are very useless to them. And we're only useful when we vote for them.
Nooit in de geschiedenis van de Zuid-Afrikaanse mijnindustrie werd er zoveel gestaakt. Maanden achtereen. Alsof ze de oude economie op de knieën willen dwingen.
Deze mijnwerkers hebben een nieuw salarisvoorstel gekregen en het is weer niet genoeg. En dan voel je aan alle kanten dat het overal borrelt, dat er overal spanning is.
Silapha namhlanje futhi esiqedwe 3 months asisebenzi.
Niyayithatha yini i-offer yomqasho? Uma ningayithathi nizothi no 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 no. Into enilwelayo. No 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 no.
De mijnwerkers voelen zich niet langer vertegenwoordigd door de vakbonden die van oudsher zijn gelieerd aan het ANC. Ze sluiten zich nu massaal aan bij vakbonden zoals de AMCU, die veel militanter zijn en de recente stakingen aansturen. De platinamijnen hier zijn in Britse handen. De miljarden die hier verdiend worden verdwijnen allemaal naar Londen. Dat was de deal van 1994. Mandela en zijn partij kregen de macht, maar de economie moest gehoorzamen naar de wetten van de markt. Het land werd uitverkocht. Het is vooral die keuze waar de stakers tegen in opstand komen. Voor de mijnwerkers geldt nu eigen volk eerst.
Before apartheid ended, I thought ANC actually was also wanted to nationalize. But then when they got the power, they forgot about that.
They didn't forget. You know what happened?
Well, they privatized.
You know what happened? What is entailed in the mining charter? What is entailed in the freedom charter? They could have implemented it. Then we will have not been in sitting with a problem like this. Because they forgot the freedom charter. If they could have implemented the freedom charter, we could have been better now as South Africans.
So it was their own promises that they didn't keep?
They didn't keep the promise. Even Mandela himself, he didn't keep the promise. Because now he's no more with us. He did things on his own. He did things not involving other people. But even today, the very same people, they seem to forget that Mandela also, when he was transferred from Robben Island to Portsmouth, he was engaging with the government without the understanding and involvement of his other comrades. What was he talking to the government? He could have involved other people so that the truth, today we can be having the truth. There is no truth about Mandela. He's only a better comrade, but we know that there are a lot of things that he didn't do it in a proper way. They are the people, they are the residents of Luka, they are members of EFF.
So they are the economic freedom fighters.
Yes.
The Malema people.
They are the Malema people, they are community members.
Hi, Bram. Nice to meet you.
Kilebugile,
good introduction.
Sure. Yeah. Thank you very much.
I hear you you're singing something about capitalists, but I don't hear the other word. What is it?
Agenda for the capitalist we don't want.
You don't want a capitalist agenda.
Yes.
And what is a capitalist agenda?
A capitalist agenda is those people who just want to come and rule, even when they've been given land to work, but now they want to control and own the land. That's the problem.
And who are those people?
Those people may be, but they can still be black, they can still be white, as long as their intention is not to empower people, but to put money only in their pocket.
But now today I saw a poster from EFF that said to the whites, the honeymoon is over. If those things that you are asking for, which is nationalization of the mines, taking back the land that was stolen from black people, if that doesn't happen very, very quickly, then what? Then what you gonna do?
It has to happen, or we gonna revolt.
How?
How? By stopping all the strategic sectors, like you saw in the past time,
like a strike.
What happened in Marikana?
Like a strike.
Not a strike, like war. It's gonna be war at the end of the day.
It's gonna be what?
War.
Like war.
Like war. If they can't resolve this right now, there's gonna be war in South Africa.
And when you talk about war, you really mean war with guns and killing and blood.
The war, you know, my friend.
As a member of AMCO, I don't think we as South Africans, we want war or we are prepared.
But that's what he's saying.
No, EFF and AMCO is not the same.
I will want to clarify.
And then another thing, war will never help us. We can sit around the table and say, or discuss issues, as you're saying, this is the situation, how are we going to solve it? Mandela showed us how to do it, then we will
do. So you don't agree with the EFF on this?
No, we are not the lady.
Is the EFF sure on?
Can I clarify this,
yes,
please?
Yes, please.
I don't think when he's talking about war, he's talking about blood war. You understand? All we're talking about is an economic war. Economic war, we simply mean the business war, meaning that we must fight for competition. You understand? No one should be superior than the other in terms of operating business.
No, but you know very well that this is all very, very dangerous play. I mean, in Marikana, 44 people were killed.
Yes.
So, I mean, we know, as you say, what war means.
When we talk of war, we will fight, but not blood. Fight.
Well, how can you fight without blood?
I can fight you business-wise.
How?
You understand? Whatever, you know, right now, we're fighting with the monopoly capitalist, if you understand what is a monopoly capitalist. Is that kind of a person who will run the business and want to be the only one running that business for many, many years. You understand? So what we are simply saying, let there be fairness in terms of operating business. Let there be competition. Let there be equal empowerment in terms of empowering people who should be, who are in that business sector.
But it looks like not everybody in the EFF thinks like that, because even your comrades.
There'll still need to be a lot of political school for many members to understand this war and this fighting. You know, this arrow does not mean I should stab you with it right now, this spear.
This arrow.
You understand? Yes. It doesn't mean you should be stabbed and then there should be blood.
Er wordt nu zoveel gestaakt in Zuid-Afrika dat de economie dreigt te krimpen. En buitenlandse investeerders zich afvragen of ze hier nog wel langer willen blijven. Het oudste mijnbouwbedrijf in het land heeft zijn platinamijnen in de verkoop gezet en wil meer machines gaan gebruiken. Want machines staken nooit.
You just sit here.
No working.
So again.
Again
you're on strike.
Even December, so until it's fumane le mali. Even December uzawufika egqithi basika ifumane imali. Basingayifumane imali akwapho singaya khona until it's fumane le mali. And thina, especially thina abantu abamnyama. Asimindi ngokuthi kwaze kwangatyiwa. Thina siyakwazi uba sisipheke onto siyityayo sitye sihluthe. Wena manje sinonile sityebile ngamanye amazwi. Ukuthi asimindi ngestrike. Sizawuhlala apha until le mali. Uba bacima mhlawumbi sawuthi ngoba becimba sizawulamba. Soze side silamise istrike. Sisuke emakhaya thina. Asiqalanga sakule ndawo. Siyayazi into eyingxaki. Asiyimayinde nto leyo. Uba manje sidimayinde ngamandla wethu. Because amandla ngawethu. Sisebenza emsebenzini. So famba ngamandla wethu sikhona uba sipheye sikhona ukwenza iingxaki zethu. That's it.
The power is yours, not the boss.
Not the boss. Power ngeza. So i-boss if I'm been figuring nigga map kwenzeka 1 2 3 mna ngepower yami leza namsebenzi if I nigga money data you lose ase.
Nelson Mandela schonk Zuid-Afrikanen het recht om te zeggen wat ze vinden. Een generatie later keert die vrijheid zich als een boemerang tegen zijn partij. Je leert een volk pas kennen niet door te kijken hoe ze met de mensen in hun hoogste klasse omgaan, maar met de laagste. Dat waren de woorden van Nelson Mandela zelf.
Thank you for watching. If you like this, please check here for the next episode or for other recommended series. And don't forget to subscribe if you want updates on upcoming new travel series.